Well, seeing as how I lean pretty heavily on Stable Diffusion to make some AI art, I guess it's finally time to have that what makes an artist conversation.
Damn it, Jim! I'm a doctor, not an artist!
Yeah, don't be so hard on yourself there, Bones. I've seen what you can do with a medical tricorder. There's true artistry there, man.
That's not art, Jim. That's skill. Skills and knowledge built up over a lifetime of practice and education.
Well, what's the real difference, Bones? Is there one?
I don't know, is there?
I don't know. Let's try and find out. What I do know is that we're going on 50 years of people pushing art out with pixels.
Who are you that flies so good? Are you insane?
No, it's just got a load of cargo in the hold and a load of bills to pay at home.
No, it's just got a load of cargo in the hold and a load of bills to pay at home.
You know, I always wonder why the voice acting on that changed and why the second guy was so much worse, but that's another story for another YouTube channel and another time. Let's talk about some art. Here's my worthless painting degree. Fresh as the day she was milled. Here's a painting I did 19 years ago. And another one from around the same time. Damn, I'm getting old. You know, actually, got a million old paintings up here that nobody wants. So here's a few more paintings and drawings of celebrities or whatever. Why am I showing you all this? So you can get a sense of my background. I don't think I'm the greatest artist in the world, but I'd like to think that I'm at least technically competent. And to me, there's two parts of being an artist. One is the creative vision, and two is having the ability to execute on that. I think a lot of people believe, quite a few people actually, that being an artist is all about technical skills and technique, and you know what, I get it. There's Van Gogh, French Impressionist, Picasso, and a lot of that stuff really is about style. But as someone who's more concerned with intent and results than they are the technical aspects of how something got made, whole AI debate's kind of funny to me. But anyway, let's take a look at the image I made and see how I did it and what AI contributed. So over the past year or so, I created hundreds of images for a top secret project that may or may not ever come out. And that's been 50% photo bashing, 40% overpainting and image manipulation, and 10% AI using Art Breeder for the faces, which I like enough to pay $8 a month for. Oh, and I've also been using David Thurin's app Photo Sketcher, which is donationware, but don't worry, I kicked him a couple bucks too. Anyway, I generally like the end result of this process and think it looks pretty good. If you like any of these images or think they're cool, then I guess subscribe to this channel and come back in 3 years. Anyway, recently I made a piece of detective stock music. Yeah, that's the one. And for that, I thought maybe it would be cool to, generate the image with AI, so here it is. Now, I like it well enough. There's some weird things going on. For example, the underside of this lamp here, you probably wouldn't see that unless the lamp was tilted because it's below the center of the frame. And this guy's probably sitting a little lower than he should be, but raising him up loses the hat, which I like as part of the composition. And the glare on his desk is maybe a little too bright for what's coming off her hand, but you know, it's art. Sometimes the weird little things are what makes the image cool. But how much of the image is AI and how much is stuff I did? Well, let's go through all the Photoshop layers and hopefully you can get a sense of it. So I'm going to just start pulling them away and hopefully you can see how the image is changing here. So this is without all the texture, kind of a cleaner image. And this is what I started with, a blank canvas.
I'd say this is the basic composition here with the detective in the foreground and the lady in the background. So as far as the composition goes, that's all human. And I really do think that's the weak point of AI right now, because I don't think it understands the rule of thirds, the golden ratio, or any of the other wacky art nonsense that humans can grasp the concept of. It just understands training off a bunch of images and then kind of like mimicking what those images are doing. So yeah, it's photo bash, but who cares, because by the time we get done with this image, you're not going to be able to recognize any of the original elements. So as far as copyright or anything like that goes, I never worry about it because I understand copyright, but doesn't mean someone can't just sue you for any reason at any time. So obviously I wanted her coat to be red, and that's an easy fix. Added a desk, different desk lamp there. And this is actually where Stable Diffusion starts to come into play. Once I had the basic composition, then I began iterating on it using image to image. And she's still wearing black here, but I pulled a few things from these backgrounds. Here's just, I think I also generated the detective. So here's a bit of shadow overpainting I did. And a little bit more. You can see the shadows just aren't quite right. Oh, here we go. This is interesting. So AI is pretty good with faces. So I went ahead and generated a few versions of her face. And also some versions of the detective's back, because that wasn't quite up to snuff, you know? A little more overpainting. There's a big manipulation of the light by me as overpainting. And there's a big change. Generating the woman in contacts with the coat now. And actually, I believe, you know, it's two of those combined, because her face, I wasn't quite jiving with her face right there. Little ear on the side there. Little fixing some nonsense there. Some nonsense there. You know, just these little changes you gotta do. Oh, right there, I didn't like the phone, so I generated a new one. And I brought back some of the original image, the hat right there, and some more overpainting. I think the big deal here is in her face. It was pretty bright, so I added a bit of shadow there. And her coat catches the light there. I think that might be a vignette, a little darkening. And then this is just all the texture stuff with Photo Sketcher. And there's the final image. Brought back some hair there at the end. And we can compare that to, we can compare that, you know, to the original quick photo bash composition. You see how much everything has changed. Now, if you're trying to do something like this from a text prompt, I don't know, let's try and do it and see what it comes up with. Now, I could go on a long rant here about Python and how adding the path variable for Anaconda breaks PaceEat and tools that I need for signing audio plugins, or how all the libraries in Python seem to be forked to hell, so trying to run scripts from even a year ago or something, they're often broken, but this is not the video. I've got a 1050 Ti here, which is a pretty ancient video card, and so I might just buy a 2060 or something just to mess around with this stuff. Well, actually, I already did, but hey, guess what? Best Buy, even though they sold it to me and took my money, ran out of stock, and so they just ended up refunding me after a few months. Anyway, generating images with this card takes a bit of time, so I'll come back in a couple of hours. So these are the images generated from my prompt, and I wouldn't say any of them are quite what I wanted. Actually, the best ones are from the simpler version of the prompt, which was pretty much the same, but didn't have the stylistic elements in them. This one is kind of in the ballpark, and you know, that one's pretty cool, but it's not really what I was going for. And the thing is, making the prompts more complicated doesn't really seem to make the image any more accurate as to what you're trying to go after. So I think the best bet with AI right now is to just generate a ton, like a metric ton of images until you get something that's relatively close to what you were going for. And then iterate over that and try to develop it. But see, by the time you do that, you might as well have just painted or photo bashed or whatever the image yourself. So going back to this series of images, AI just doesn't understand how to do a three shot, a dirty two shot, a dirty three shot, or even just a series of images based on the same subject. Although it kind of can with training and dream booth, it's a lot of work for the user. Concept artists and illustrators aren't going to have their jobs taken away anytime soon because so much of that work is just editing and design, and you still need an artist's eye to do it. And the people who do that kind of work, they're just going to incorporate AI into their workflow. So I'm old enough to remember when Photoshop and Corel Painter first came out and people were saying that digital painting was going to be the end of art. Then it was photo bashing and 3D rendering, and there's always a bad guy. AI is just the new kid on the block, but at the end of the day, it's just a tool. Might be a fancy tool and a new tool, and sure, maybe a bit of a scary tool, but it's not going to replace anyone because it's only really good at specific things. It can do pretty one-off anime portraits, and it kind of struggles at everything else. Now, it is getting better every day, and the time might come when it really is just as good as a human, but when that day hits us, I think AI art's probably going to be the least of our problems because we're going to have to ask ourselves deep philosophical questions about what it means to be human. And until then, don't freak out, man.
Now, as far as the ethics involved go, training off a living artist and all that, I'm sorry, but everybody does it. Style is really just the culmination of a lifetime's worth of experience and influence. Work you admire, work you're trying to emulate. Nobody exists in a vacuum, and AI is just taking that process and ramping it up 10,000%. Now, the trouble comes when people try to claim credit for work they didn't really do, but the people who are going to end up making the most amazing images with this stuff are going to be the ones who put the time and effort into truly understanding and mastering it. In other words, people willing to do the work. And as far as painting and drawing go, so much of that is about the process, putting actual paint and ink down on a paper or canvas, and AI can't replace that. Although someday maybe specialized robots will. But you can't be afraid of change and new technology, because that's all the story of humanity ever really was.